This is ASUS's top tier cooler, and it's huge and expensive, and I want to see what's inside, and I hope it performs, and it should. It's got three Noctua IPPC fans. It's got another fan on top of the cooler for like bonus cooling, and a 3.5-inch screen if that's what you're into. I don't think it can play Doom though, so negative points for that, but hopefully it should do pretty well. And we're gonna find out on a huge test bench I have over here. Let's see what's inside. Okay. Well, classic ROG, it is well presented and well packed. We've got clearly the cooler right here. Looks to be an inch thick. It's 360 millimeters. There is a 360 mil and a 240 mil version of this. It is very crinkly, so I'm gonna take off these bags. Ooh! It's not particularly long, but there's the big old screen there. Got pre-applied thermal paste, nice. And under this screen is where that bonus fan is. I hope I can take that off and take a look. Let's see what else is in the box first. Oh, it comes with a fan hub. Yeet. Cooler installation guide. Stickers. Love stickers. Just want bigger stickers. Ah, my favorite thing in the world is in here. Wait for it. VHB, the answer to all life's problems. Stick anything to anything, as long as it's not like gas. Ah, ooh, these are nice. These are our Noctua fans. Now, if you're paying this much money for a cooler, you better get the best of the best when it comes to fans. So these are 2000 RPM, 120 mil Noctua IPPC fans, and it's just top tier, and they're black. Yeah, I remember Linus doing a video where he tested these underwater. These are like 30 bucks a piece. So like, here you go, 90 bucks worth of fans. So the MSRP on the 360 millimeter version is $310. And that's a lot of money, but it gets worse. Right now on Newegg, these are selling for $550. I don't know why, just don't pay that much money for this. But when you add up the cost of all these parts, it kind of makes sense. So we have 90 bucks worth of fans here. I mean, what's a rad this big cost, John? Like 80, 90 bucks, something along those lines. You got the screen, which you can't really just integrate yourself or do it this well anyway. You got the fan on top of an ASUS 7th gen pump and all the mounting hardware that you could dream of. And you don't have to buy fittings or any of that jazz. It's just sealed. It's easy. You know, what's your time worth too, right? If you got to spend 4 hours configuring a custom loop, and that's on the light side. You know, if you price yourself really low at 15 bucks, call that another 60 bucks. So there is a value proposition here for simplicity and a screen. Ah, so it looks like the standard bracket that comes mounted on here won't fit because the socket is bigger. So we'll have to twist. Is it a lock ring? How does this work? Get, there we go, boop, that comes off. And I gotta be careful not to get thermal paste all over my shiny new reflective shirt from lcdstore.com. Let's get to putting this thing on, shall we? I gotta take off the tried and true D15S. Anthony already benchmarked it for me, so I know what sort of performance to expect out of a top tier air cooler. We'll see how this water cooler stands up. Now we're removing SecuFirm 2, which is already the best in the industry, in my opinion. And we'll see how this mounting system works and how easy it is comparatively. The cooler has Noctua fans, but the mounting hardware is not SecuFirm 2. I would buy it immediately if it was. Give it to everyone. We're tired. We're sick and tired of bad mounting systems. ASMR. I should have probably read the instructions here. I'm just gonna put a couple headers in here so I don't lose this, and then I'm going to double check the instructions. So I haven't used the mounting system on one of these open bench tables for an AIO. So we're gonna figure out how that works. So this board has huge VRMs, fine, but like I can't get a screwdriver in there to drive the Phillips head, let alone turn the darn thing. That's not great. This is not SecuFirm. Anything less than SecuFirm is not great in my opinion. The struggle bus is here and I am all aboard. Okay, Jono grabbed me some tweezers. Not tweezers, pliers. Okay, well, that's as much mounting pressure as we're gonna get today anyway. Oh! Interesting, okay.
Now we know.
Well, there's that that bonus fan, and that would have changed. Why? Is that in the manual? Yeah, it doesn't say anything about that pops off.
We gotta solve the problem.
Yes, absolutely. I can see the screws now. It's not funny. Okay, you know, your instructions are useless. But inside here, this is pretty cool. A big old ribbon cable, so there's gonna be a graphics driver on here somewhere. This ribbon cable will feed the display. Got some pins that rest in these holes. So this is what's gonna cool all these VRMs. So we're gonna get airflow down through and around out to around these heatsink fins, and it'll help move heat away from the VRM. So in theory, that'll be handy. These are PWM fans, so they're all individually controllable, I think. Not bad. Oh, there comes everything else. It's a big display, like 3.5 inches is not a tiny display to have on top of your USB. And then we can finally hit the power button. And watch these beautiful Noctuas spin up. I'm gonna turn them towards you so you can see all that action. But before that, James has a message for you.
Today's video is brought to you by Wealthfront. We are super excited to share a service that makes investing feel a lot more stable. If you're someone who wants to get into investing or continue to diversify your portfolio, Wealthfront makes it super easy and affordable to get started. You can build your own portfolio through Wealthfront and invest in sectors you really believe in, like healthcare or clean energy, for example. Here's the kind of thing Wealthfront's clients are experiencing. Their software monitors your portfolio so you can rebalance it based on your preferences, making sure your level of risk stays right where you want it. They also look for tax loss harvesting opportunities on a daily basis to potentially lower your overall tax bill. Whatever your investing goals are, Wealthfront has your back. So check them out at the link below and get a special sign-up bonus.
And we're back. Power on. Whoa. It's not that bad. Those fans are pushing some air though. Okay, anyway, so at idle, CPU package is sitting at 27 degrees. Like, that's low. That's where I'd expect it to be. Okay, we've got Armory Crate installed. We have Blender ready to go on a Gooseberry benchmark. We've upped the samples to 1200 from 600. Should run for about 10 minutes, and we're monitoring the CPU package and core max temperature. Let's hit F12, boop. Renders. Okay, big spike up to 60. And we're down to 41, so we should hear the fans start to ramp up here. So with the D15S, after 10 minutes, our hottest core was at 98°C, the CPU package is at 97. Equilibrium temp is 92 to 93. So we're at 69, nice. Let's see how long it takes to actually like hit a good equilibrium. This might take a little while. CPU is pulling 205 watts. So, I mean, it's working. I don't run Gooseberry very often, so I don't know if this is fast or slow, but regardless, we're hitting it with 205 watts and it's sitting at 69 degrees. Nice. This is wrong. CPU core zero, like all these cores are at 4.9. Oh, wait, there's our efficiency cores, 3.7. Like, it's just sitting at 67 degrees. So I feel pretty confident in saying that this cooler is doing its job. It's quiet, it's expensive, but it does its job. Inside a case, it would be a different story. So we do need to acknowledge that if this was in a case, it would perform way differently, you know, call it 5-10 degrees, but then you're still at 70 degrees, which is fine. There's like headroom for overclocking there. I want to check the VRM temperatures. VRM temperatures, like 45 degrees right now. It's nothing. This is a good, I'm gonna say it, this is a good cooler. It's tasty, so like, I'm not that surprised. You know, but it is expensive, but the time you save with it is probably worth it, and you got a big screen on it. Ooh, should we try to play with the screen? Is that the last thing we should do? Yeah, okay. So we can play around with the screen. We're just gonna use the 3 built-in graphics, unless, Jono, did you get one for me? Okay, we didn't anyway, but it updates rather quickly. And boop, there's number 1. And number 2. And Retrowave, my favorite. Yeah. So like the screen works, it's bright, it looks good. I mean, you can put whatever GIF or GIF, whatever you prefer to say it on it, and it performed really well. So if this 360 will fit in your case, go for it. If it doesn't, use the 240. And if you can afford it, that is too. I mean, an air cooler is obviously going to be cheaper, but this is, well, chilly. It works. And with that, thanks for watching Short Circuit. Get subscribed. Check out more of our videos in our back catalog, and I'll see you on another day.